حي على الفلاح
Amongst those certain aspects of life as well is a concept of death, which is we find that many people want to deny or stay away from. That the beginning is in the womb of the mother, then he comes out into the dunya, then he enters into the barzakh, and then he goes back into the akhirah, either in a state of happiness in bliss or either in a state of sadness. However, the majority of mankind wants to take the path of evil. And that's why we find, unfortunately, that on a long journey, everybody will discuss every single aspect of their life. But when it comes to the topic, you say to them, do you know we're going to die one day? That person will say, stop there. Don't carry on this discussion anymore. That is enough. Even though this is the greatest reality that will hit insan, but he refuses to discuss this topic, feeling shy about this topic, or not recognizing the truth about this topic, that he has to return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all of this is known, the unseen affairs. Whatever will happen to an insan, in the barzakh, in the interspace, or inside the grave, or towards the akhirah, is all unknown. Only belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the whole Quran begins with this message in Surah Al-Baqarah, that this is the book that there is no doubt, no discrepancy. For those people, الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ, who believe in the unseen. This is the teaching after Surah Al-Fatiha, that the whole this Quran, whatever it mentions about the akhirah, is unseen. And the believer should strongly believe in that which will happen to the individual. And we want to look at our perception of al-maut, because many of us don't seem to comprehend the understanding of al-maut, because we are suffering from at the moment al-wahan, hubbu dunya wa karahatu al-maut, a love of this world and a hatred for death. And that's how we find the mention of death. Kullu nafsin dha'ikatu al-maut, every single soul should taste death. Likewise we find wa ma tadri nafsum madha taksibu ghada, no soul will know what it will earn tomorrow. وَمَا تَدْرِ نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ, and no soul knows where it will die. Likewise, they find كُلُّ مَنْ عَلَيْهَا فَانْ وَيَبْقَى وَجْهُ رَبِّكَ ذُو الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ, every single thing on this land will perish, will come to an end, except for the noble, glorious face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And likewise, they find أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ حَتَّى زُرْتُمُ الْمَقَابِرِ, the rivalry of this dunya takes you away until you visit the graves, meaning until death comes upon you. وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ, worship your Lord until death comes upon you. That is the meaning of yaqeen in this verse towards the end of Surah Al-Hijr. Continuously worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until you are lifted up by Him. That is what it means by certainty. The first time that we find كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَاعِكَةُ الْمَوْتِ وَإِنَّمَا تُوَفَّوْنَا أُجُورَكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, verily you will be given your full recompense on the Day of Judgment. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ, وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاءُ الْغُرُورِ, whoever is saved from the hellfire, that is supreme success, and thrown into paradise, فَقَدْ فَاز, that individual is a successful one. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاءُ الْغُرُورِ, and the whole of this dunya is one great big deception, as described by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا هَذِي الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا لَهُمْ وَلَعِبْ, what is this dunya except for play and amusement. وَإِنَّ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ لَحِيَ الْحَيَوَانَ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ, and a final abode, the final resting place, that is the real home of the believer. And likewise we find, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسَرٍ, that the majority of mankind are forever going towards a state of loss. And simply the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, be in this dunya as if you are a traveler or a wayfarer, stranger, غُرَبَى, that's what we are in this dunya. The second time that we find, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَاعِكَةُ الْمَوْتِ, in Surah Al-Anbiya, that we find, then we find, وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ, then we make a trial for you through the good and the bad, and then you'll return back to us once again. And the third time we find this verse in Surah Al-Ankabut, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَاعِكَةُ الْمَوْتِ ثُمَّ إِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ, then once again you'll return back to us. Every single calamity, everything that happens to an individual, any calamity, loss of fruit, of wealth, of property, anything that you own, this is the way of the mu'min, the believer, to say to Allah we belong, and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we will return. And that's why we find that those people who deny death, you think we created you in vain, in jest, no purpose. So the heavens and the earth serve a purpose, and likewise insan serves a purpose, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for those people who think, many people think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot recreate creation once again. To Allah belongs the greatest similitude. Insan, after creating something, can return and recreate the same thing again. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates something between the command of be and it is. Create something out of nothing. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why he states to al-insan, does insan not see that he's been created from nutfa? In another place in the Quran, created from filthy semen. فَإِذَا هُوَ خَصِيمٌ مُّبِينٌ. And he begins to be a clear opponent towards us. Debate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he brings forth a parable to us. And he forgets his own creation. Forgets the essence of himself. That he is from this filthy water, who is going to bring these bones back to life when they are dust. Who is going to do that? Is he challenged to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds, say indeed he will bring them back to life, who brought it life in the first place. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he has the power and the ability and has the knowledge over the whole of creation. As for those people who want to run away from death, قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. Say the death that you are trying to run away from, فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ, for verily it will meet you one day. And then he will inform you the knower of the seen and the unseen, of that what you used to do. Likewise, we find that some people believe that paradise is specifically for them. That many Muslims walk around with this label as well, that paradise is only for them. The same verse goes to these people as well. If you believe that paradise is specifically for you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created it for you and given it to you, then aspire to taste death. And these people never aspire to taste death because they are zalimeen. Because they know they're not befitting to enter into the paradise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And likewise we find, and really when the ajal comes, the appointed time comes, there'll be no delaying and no bringing it forward, the time of the ajal, the time of the death that will come upon that individual. And likewise we find that those people who want to hide inside their mansions and their palaces, that they build them and they think that these things can fortify them. Once again the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wherever you are, death will come upon you even if you be inside your fortified palaces. And every single person has an angel assigned to them with the authority to lift up that individual soul and take them back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as for some of us, our property and our children have distracted us from maut. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُلْهِكُمْ أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُكُمْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Don't let your children and your wealth become a distraction from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. And those people are the losers. وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ. Spend in the way of Allah before death comes upon you. And then what does that individual state then? فَيَقُولَ رَبِّ لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ. If only you give me some respite, so I may go back and spend charity. At that stage it's too late to say, now send me back. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states to him, كَلَّا إِنَّهَا كَلِمَةٌ هُوَ قَائِلُهَا. Nay, these are only empty words, baseless words that he's saying now. Verily there's a barzakh that is placed in front of him, there's no going back for this individual. As for what will happen to the individual after death, what will happen to the individual when they are lifted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And we find that there's no repentance when the soul is about to be taken out of the throat. And that's what we find inside the Quran, فَلَوْلَا إِذَا بَلَغَتِ الْحُلْقُومِ. That when death comes to your throat, وَأَنْتُمْ حِينَ إِذٍ تَنْظُرُونَ. At that stage you are looking. وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْكُمْ وَلَكِنْ لَا تُبْصِرُونَ. And we are closer to you, closer to that individual than you are, but you cannot perceive us and you cannot see us. فَلَوْلَا إِنْ كُنْتُمْ غَيْرَ مَدِينِينَ. If you think you are free from accountability, تَرَجِعُونَهَا إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Then return that soul back if you are truthful. That once that time comes, there is no going back. Likewise we find, وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتُ مِنْهُ تَحِيدٌ. Verily the stupor, the taking of death, the quick taking of death will come, the amazement of death, the startlement of death will come upon you. That is what you is trying to stay away from. Will come upon every single individual. And the greatest hadith, which talks about what will happen to an individual after death comes to them, is the hadith of Bara ibn Azib. In this long hadith that we find, that an individual, when the believer leaves this world, and angels with faces as white as the sun, carrying shrouds of paradise, and the perfume of paradise is placed upon these shrouds, will come to this good soul, and say, good soul, come out to forgiveness and acceptance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the soul comes out, like a drop of water is taken out of a water skin. That is the way a good soul will come out. And then it'll be taken up, and it'll be said, who is this good soul? And by every single good name in this dunya, that soul will be mentioned. Continuously being lifted up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, lifted all the way through the heavens, up to the seventh heaven. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, record the book of my servant in Illiyun, in the highest record, and take him back to the earth. For verily I created him from the earth, and he shall return to it and from it I shall bring him out once again. And then it will be said to him, who is your Lord? And he'll be given the tawfiq and ability to say, Rabbi Allah, my Lord is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is your deen? What is your religion? Who is this man that was sent to you? And what is your source of knowledge? And that person who lived according to the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this dunya will be given that ability. Say the correct answers. And likewise you find that a man with a beautiful face will come to him with a good smell. And you say, who are you? He will say, I am your good deeds. My Lord, bring Aqimisa'a, bring the last hour so that I may return to my people and my property. And another hadith will be stated, sleep like the newlywed bride. Sleep in this manner. No worries at all for that individual. As for the individual who is the fajir, the fasiq, a rebellious person, then angels with black faces will come down upon that individual. And he will say, oh wicked soul, come out to Allah's displeasure and anger. And they will be carrying sacks, evil black sacks, with a foul stench. And they will at this person's soul. And a foul stench will come from this individual's soul. And it will be taken up. And it will say, oh wicked soul, every single wicked name in this dunya that that person was called by will be called as it's traveling up. And the doors of paradise will not open. Will only go to the lowest heaven and that is it. And you find that the doors of paradise will be sealed for that individual. And they will never ever enter into paradise until the camel goes through the eye of the needle, which is impossible. And then it will be said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, record his record in Sijjin, in the lowest record, and then it will be thrown down from the heavens down to the lowest earth. And then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited the verse, وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّيْ فَكَأَنَّمَا خَرَّ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ أَوْ تَخْتَفَهُ الطَّيْرُ أَوْ تَحْوِي بِهِ رِيحُ فِي مَكَانٍ سَحِيقٍ. That what the example is individual is as the bird has thrown him down from the heavens, or the wind snatches him away, takes him away to a faraway place. This is the example of shirk billahi azza wa jal. Then we said to him, who is your Lord? What is your religion? And who is this man that was sent to you? And he will say, la adri, la adri. A form in the Arabic language, I don't know. It will say, kathabd, you have lied. Because he will know everything. This is the only exam that every single person in this dunya has the answer. But they won't be able to say it on that day. No one cannot say it except by the tawfiq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And say, yeah, he has lied. Spread out the carpets for hell for him and open a gate of hell for him. And it will say that some of the hot air comes inside there. And the grave is made narrow. And a man with an ugly face and ugly garments will come in front of him with an offensive smell. And he say, be grieved with what displeases you. For this is your day which you have promised. He said, who are you? Say, I am your wicked deeds. My Lord, do not bring the last hour. My Lord, do not bring the last hour. And that's why we find Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, he mentions that the place of the grave, and even before that, Uthman ibn Affan, if you are successful inside the grave, everything will be successful for you. Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, he mentions the link between qabr and qalb. Is the verse inside the Quran, أَفَلَا يَعْلَمُ إِذَا بُعْثِرَ مَا فِي الْقُبُورِ وَحُصِّلَ مَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. The qalb is the place which hides all of your hidden secrets. Nobody knows it except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And likewise the qabr, nobody knows what happens inside the grave except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Both are concealed confinements. What is inside the heart and what is inside the grave. That's why these philosophers, they believe that there must be some movement inside the grave. So they took some mercury and they placed it inside the grave. Because mercury moves at great speed, or anything makes mercury move. They placed it there, hoping to see that when they dig up the grave, the mercury will move and we'll see that some effects of Adhab al-Qabr. How foolish these people are. They think that they can judge everything by their rationale, by philosophy. This is barzakh, this is the interspace, that nobody knows what will happen except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's how we find that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam sought refuge from the punishment of the grave. And likewise we find that the na'im of the grave has been mentioned inside the Quran as well. قِيلَ دُخُلِ الْجَنَّةِ قَالَ يَا لَيْتَ قَوْمِ يَعْلَمُونَ. If you say to an individual, enter into paradise. He's entering into paradise inside the grave. The bliss has been given to this individual inside that location. And finally, we need to reflect upon الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةِ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. He's the one that created life and death to see which of you is best in action. Not أَكْثَرُ عَمَلًا, the most in action, but the best in action. The most precision in action. Ikhlas, and upon the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's how we find all of us should aspire to die upon good actions. Standing in a salah, in qiyam, in ruku, in sujood, reading the Quran, performing tawaf, making hajj. That is the way a person should aspire. But if not that, at least aspire to die in a good manner. Because really the way that you die is the way that you'll be resurrected. And that's how all of us want to fall into that verse. يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّةِ ارْجِعِي إِلَىٰ رَبِّكِ رَاضِيَةً مَرْضِيَّةً فَادْخُلِي فِي عِبَادِي وَادْخُلِي جَنَّتِي. O soul at rest, return back to the paradise. Return back amongst my servants. Enter into my paradise. The soul which is at rest. And that soul is at rest by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us the tawfiq and the ability to understand the truth about death and strive to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our challenge towards running towards Him, to get closer and closer to Him and protect us from the punishment of the grave and the rest of the calamities that we're facing at the moment. Wa jazakumullah khair.